All right, so we're going to start talking about geometric optics. I want to start with the simplest optical system that generates that can be used to form images. We'll talk about plane surfaces, so reflecting surfaces like a mirror, for example, or refracting surfaces like if you have an object that's immersed in a pool of water and you're looking down. So let's take the mirror to begin with. So here's a mirror. What the mirror is usually a piece of glass with a metal coating on the back, so that the metal is the most important thing. The metal is very reflective if you polish it, and so light rays that come in will reflect off nearly 100%. You don't get much transmission or absorption. All right, so let's have an object in front of this mirror. Here you are standing in front of your mirror. So we're going to talk about how when we look in a mirror, we see an image there. The question is, how does that get formed? So first of all, when we think about an object, which is you standing here, the object emits light, and these light rays will travel from the object to the mirror and be reflected. So if you look at a point on your head here, there are light rays being emitted in all directions. Okay, and I can do this at every point on your body. You have basically rays being emitted from your skin, your hair, so forth and so on. Now, of course, you're not glowing actively on your own. The reason this happens is there's a lamp above your head, or the sun is shining on you, and your body absorbs and re-emits that light. Okay, and that light carries with it information about your body, the color of your hair, color of your skin, so forth and so on. Okay, all right, let's clean this up here. And what I'll do is I'll pick a couple of rays here. So what we can do is take a few rays that come from this top spot on your head. Take one that goes like this and hits the mirror. And I'm going to have an observer. Okay. So here I am observing. Now, of course, I can directly see you. But I'm interested in what I see in the mirror. Okay. All right. So this is a perfect reflection. So angle of incidence, see if I can get this right, will equal angle of reflection. So I'm going to get a reflection that comes back like this. I can take another ray that, say, does this and then reflects. Okay. Now, the observer here sees these diverging rays. Okay. And if I view these rays, if the rays are, you know, I see them with my eye. Again, as we've talked about already, the way we perceive the location or the object that the rays came from is by looking for where the rays diverge from. Okay, so if I follow these rays back here behind the mirror, to me it appears they're coming from right here. Okay. And I can do this for a variety of rays coming from different parts of the objects from your body, okay? And if I do that, I can trace out an image, okay? That will be on the other side of the mirror. And this is what I perceive, okay? I perceive the light, that this is the image I see in the mirror, okay? And to me, it looks like the light rays coming to my eye are coming from this image. Now, a few things about plane mirrors. So this construction that I've done here, you can do formally. I've done it a little, not as carefully as I could, but two things to point out. First of all, the image location, if you take the mirror as the origin, if I have an object that's distance S, the image is at distance S prime, and you can show that these two are equal. Now, the other thing I can prove is that the height of the image is going to be y prime. The height of the object will be y. You can show that the magnification for a plane mirror, which is defined as the height of the image over the height of the object, is 1. These two things are equal, okay, in a plane mirror. So if you go to a funhouse and look at a curved mirror, you see your body stretched out in funny ways. But looking in your bathroom mirror, you see exactly the same size image as you, okay? All right. So that's for a plane mirror. The same kind of argument applies to a pool. Okay, so if you have I should use blue. Here we go. So if I have a lake or a pool of water down here, and I put my fishy in there. Okay, here's my fishy. Okay, that's not a very well-drawn fishy, but that's all right. Now the light rays that come from the fish, as we've already talked about in class, but just to reiterate, the light rays that come from the fish, if I'm observing up here, here's my eye, and I'm watching these light rays, when they come out of the water, they bend away from the normal. It's going from a high index to a low index. And so if I see these rays, I perceive that they came from a point that's slightly higher than the fish. So if I go through this process and trace out all of these different rays, I'm going to find that I see a fish that, that sits up here. Okay? That's what I perceive to be the case. Now in this case, I don't see this the fish, I don't see this and this. I just see the fish. Okay, that's elevated up. That's what I perceive when I look at this system. Okay, now these types of images in both cases here are called virtual images. And the reason for that is that the rays that we are looking at, so either these rays here up top or these rays here, are merely diverted in their path. Okay, and so and they continue to diverge. Okay. So the mirror and the plane surface, what they do is just redirect diverging rays. Okay, they don't do any focusing. So when I trace back these diverging rays, it appears to be coming from a location where there is no real source of light. Okay, now we'll be talking about real images. So real images are formed when you have an optical system that doesn't redirect diverging rays, but instead makes rays converge. So if you can take rays that are coming off of my body and refocus them down to a point, in that case, you can form what's called a real image, and that's what we'll talk about next. All right, but before we end this video, one more concept to cover, and that's the concept of multiple plane surfaces. And this is a discussion problem that you'll see in discussion if you haven't already, and we'll also do a demo in class. But if I imagine I have more than one plane mirror, so let's imagine I have two, and I can put them at some angle with respect to each other, say a right angle here. So when you talk about image formation, in this case, you have the possibility of rays that can bounce off of one more than one mirror in order to form an image. So let's start first. Let's put an object here, say. Okay, that's emitting light. Now, what we just talked about previously tells us that I'm going to have, here, I'll tell you what, let me move this down a little bit here, see if I can do that. Okay, there we go. Okay, great. All right, so if I put an object here, some distance d1 from one mirror, distance d2 from the other. Okay, the images formed in the two mirrors will follow the same principle we just talked about. I'm going to have an image that sits here, that's equidistant, a distance d1, apparent, the apparent distance into the mirror, and another image here. Okay, and those I could draw rays for, but I won't do that. Okay, now there will be another image that's formed because of what I might say is the image of the images. Okay, so I can do this one of two ways. Let me first just say, let's imagine that I have a ray that comes off of one mirror. Okay, so let's take this ray that bounces, and let me try to do this right, and let me switch colors so we can see it. Okay, all right, then a ray bounces here, and then comes off of this mirror, and then bounces like that. Okay, and let's pick another one that might go here, okay, then here, then here. Okay, and if I've done it right, okay, these rays will appear to be coming, and I haven't done it quite right, so I'm going to cheat. Okay, I'm going to put it right there. Okay, so there's going to be another apparent image formed by rays that bounce more than once off of these mirrors. Okay, and the easiest way to find that is actually to think about extending the mirrors like this, this isn't really where the mirrors are. And then I can use the images that are formed as objects for the other mirror. So for example, if I take this image, which is formed by this mirror here, this mirror over here will form an image of that image, okay? And I find that image by extending the mirror back down, or imagining extending it. In reality, I think, I can think about this guy providing these rays that I've drawn here, and then I get an image of that. So I don't have to think about extending the mirror. It turns out that this mirror will form an image here without extending it, but I can imagine that the image is a distance equidistant across this extended mirror. Okay, and I can do the same thing with this image here. So this image is an image of this object in this mirror. So now if I image it across this mirror, I get the same image here. Okay, so I can get multiple image formation in mirrors where I have multiple surfaces, multiple plane surfaces next to each other at an angle. And I'll show a demo in class, and you can, I basically did your discussion problem for you, but you'll think about this again in discussion. All right, let me stop here.